There is water on the floor.
தரையிலே தண்ணீர் இருக்கிறது.
And you are busy mopping it up.
அந்த தண்ணியை அகற்றும்படியாக நீங்கள் துடைத்துக் கொண்டிருக்கிறீர்கள்.
Without turning the tap off.
நீர் குழாயை அடைக்காதபடி அதை நீங்கள் செய்ய முயற்சி செய்கிறீர்கள்.
As long as the tap is open, the water will not stop flowing.
நீர் குழாயை நீங்கள் அடைக்காத வரை அந்த நீர் தொடர்ந்து வடிந்து கொண்டுதான் இருக்கும். அதை நீங்கள் தடுக்க முடியாது.
Jesus told his disciples in John 16 verse 33, "Be of good cheer, I have overcome the world."
ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்து, திடன் கொள்ளுங்கள் என்று.
In the same John 19:28, he said, "It is finished." These were statements of firm promises by the Savior of the world. Peace in Christ is the only true peace. There is no other peace.
உலகத்தின் இரட்சகராகிய ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவிடமிருந்து கடந்து வருகிறதில் கிடையாது.
Christ has overcome the world before us, and he has given a permanent blow to all our problems. Tell your neighbor, permanent blow.
ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்து அவர் செய்த செய்கையினாலே.
This will lead us to the message titled "A Lasting Solution." Tell your neighbor, "A Lasting Solution."
ஒரு நிறைவான தீர்வை நாம் காண வந்திருக்கிறோம். அருகாமையில் இருப்பவர் இடத்தில் சொல்லுங்கள்.
And this will take us to the book of Mark 2.
மூன்றாம் அதிகாரம்.
When Jesus again entered the Capernaum, the people heard that he had come home. So many gathered that there was no room left, not even outside the door. And he preached the word to them. Some of them came, bringing to him a paralytic, carried by four men. Since they could not get in to Jesus because of the crowd, they made an opening in the roof above Jesus. After digging through it, lowered the mat the paralyzed man was lying on. When Jesus saw their faith, you know, we talked about faith. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven." You know, the people were expecting Jesus to say, "Rise and walk." But instead, Jesus said, "Go, your sins are forgiven." Usually, anything that cannot be quantified at all, at least considered by worldly people. When you tell the worldly people you are blessed, they say, "Where is the blessing you are talking about?" When you tell the people of the world you are healed, they say, "Where is the healing?" They were expecting Jesus to say, "Rise and walk." Instead, Jesus said, "Your sins are forgiven."
இந்த கதையில் நடைபெறுகிற சம்பவம் என்னவென்றால், திமிர்வாதக்காரன் ஒருவனை சொல்லுகிறார், "உன் பாவம் மன்னிக்கப்பட்டது, நீ கடந்து செல்" என்று.
Usually, anything that cannot be quantified, at least considered by worldly people. The things of God cannot be quantified in terms of money and position at all.
ஆண்டவர் வழங்கக்கூடிய கிருபையானது உலகத்தின் வழக்கப்படி நாம் கணக்கிட முடியாது.
They were expecting Jesus to say, "Rise and walk," but Jesus went straight to the root. This is why we talk about a lasting solution. Today, people bother about the solution to a problem rather than its cause. Today, people bother about healing rather than about sin, the cause of sickness. Today, people bother about blessing, I want to be blessed, rather than about sin, the cause of poverty. Today, people bother about breakthrough everywhere. When you go around, you see people breakthrough, rather than about the sin, the cause of disappointment.
In the Kadayale Nam Kanava Murkari Menavendal, and the Brachanaik Tirvana or Mudivakana Vendum, Yen Brother Kaga.
When you bother about a problem, neglecting its cause, you cannot have a lasting solution. When you bother about solution to a problem rather than about its cause, you cannot have a lasting solution. That is why the problem keeps recurring.
ஒரு பிரச்சனைக்கு தீர்வு காண வேண்டும் என்று நாம் அனைவரும் ஆசைப்படுகிறோம். தலை தூக்குவதை நாம் காண்கிறோம்.
The problem keeps recurring because we deal with this problem, neglecting its cause, its root, its source. When you deal with the problem, neglecting its cause, it's like dealing with the branches of a tree, neglecting its roots. Sin is the cause of all pains. What do I mean by pain? Whatever gives you discomfort.
எந்த ஒரு காரியம் உங்களுக்கு வேதனையை தருகிறதோ அதுவே வழி என்று நான் கருதுகிறேன்.
Whatever gives you discomfort, the way to move it, to move the pain, is to take away the cause. Pardon of sin, forgiveness of sin, extracts the root of all pains. The root of sickness, the root of affliction, the root of just naming. When Jesus said, "Go, your sins are forgiven," he was dealing with the root. Tell your neighbor, forgiveness of sin strikes the root of all pains. When Jesus said, "Go, your sins are forgiven," he equally meant to say, "Go, you are healed indeed." Because sin is the disease of the soul. Tell your neighbor, sin is the disease of the soul. I can't hear you.
Sin is the disease of the soul.
Sin is the disease of the soul. When it is pardoned, you are healed.
ஆன்மாவிலே காணப்படக்கூடிய வியாதி தான் பாவம். அது தீர்க்கப்படும் வேளையிலே நீங்கள் விடுதலை பெறுகிறீர்கள்.
What are you facing that is giving you discomfort? Whatever gives you discomfort, sin is the cause. This was what Jesus meant when he said, "Go, your sins are forgiven." This means when you are healed of sin, you are healed indeed.
Amen. நீ சுகமாக்கப்பட்டாய் என்றுதான் பொருள்.
For instance, a man who has a headache as a result of stress, as a result of hard work, he will continue to have a temporary relief unless he learns to observe quality rest.
அப்படியே தங்குகிறது.
What do I mean? Those healed of the punishment of sin are likely to return to sin when the pains, when the hard times, when poverty are over, they are likely to return. This is why Jesus said, go, your sins are forgiven. Sin brings sickness and death. Satan is the author of them all. That is, Satan is synonymous with sin. Anything Satan is capable of doing, sin is capable of.
நாம் காண வேண்டிய காரியம் இதுதான் பிரியமானவர்களே.
Whatever you are facing now, why can't you track the road for a lasting solution? Redemption forever. Healing forever. Track the road. Are you ready to track the road?
Amen.
And stop complaining.
Amen.
Thank you.